Hey, good morning. It's Dr. James. I hope you're off to a beautiful start today. It's so wonderful to lay eyes on you. Thank you for your time. And thank you for your energy. And this morning, I have one intention, that this message literally lands right here in your heart and it never leaves. It just imprints itself at a cellular level and a soulful level. And you never forget what this is all about, because this is probably the most important thing that I am learning every single day. And it comes in the heels of a presentation I did in Canada a couple months ago. And I was doing this presentation, I was literally being asked to speak for a day and a half. And you're like, wow, I don't know if I could listen to that guy, James, for a day and a half. Well, you know what? I spoke for a day and a half, and I have to tell you, I built the most amazing PowerPoint. I say amazing, not like the content was amazing. It was 120 slides. I was like, oh my gosh, I've got 10 hours of presenting. I gotta make sure I have. And guess what? For a day and a half, I never ever used one slide. And it's amazing more and more as I get a chance to do presentations and speak all over the world. I seldom use slides anymore because I've learned the secret to doing the great work of my life. And it has nothing to do with me. It has everything to do with God, the universe, the divine. Just getting out of the way and letting that divine energy, that wisdom, that light come through me. Just get out of the way, James, get out of the way. Well, I was speaking about success. And this is basically what came through. And I want to share a diagram with you that I designed on the fly. And it pretty much tells the story of why some people are wildly successful and some people are really happy and some people really come here and they live their purpose, they love out loud, and when it's time to go, they go whole. They go with a sense of peace because they live their purpose. And you ready for this? This is what it's all about. Passion and compassion intersecting, calling the space of grace. Right here, you've got your passion, which is your purpose, your dharma, your reason for being, the reason you get up in the morning. Your compassion and knowing that this is the earth school. You get a chance to learn. You're gonna stumble. You're gonna fall. You are gonna find yourself in spaces where you question everything and your faith wants to fade. And if we can couple these two spaces together, we are living our passion and we're being a student of what makes us come alive. We occupy the space of grace. So you simply today need to give yourself the opportunity to ask yourself a simple question. What makes you come alive? What makes you feel most awake, most courageous? What brings forth that sense of possibility and that sense of, oh my gosh, I know exactly what I want to be standing for. These are my values, these are my principles, and I am practicing them. And I have the compassion to know that I am a student of this. And this is not about being perfect. This is simply deciding with an absolute knowing that I am going to show up and lean all the way into my life's purpose. Because when you bring passion and compassion together, right here is where you occupy. That is the space of grace. In the space of grace, is where you are most alive. It is where joy happens. It is where humility happens. It is where vulnerability shines through you. And vulnerability is where the birthplace of love and light and purpose and dharma and showing up with your heart out loud. That's what comes through you. I would love for you to take a snapshot of this. I would love for you to write this down. But more importantly, I'd love for you to practice your passion with compassion. And see what it feels like to live in your space of grace. I am with you, I am for you, and I love you. Many blessings. Bye for now.